Innovation Centre is in dialogue with Marianne Balesquemas from the European Commission DG Employment, Social Affairs and Inclusion. Marianne, you've been here today at the Interact on private money for public good, looking at the issue of disability in focus. Can you tell us, from what you're doing at the European Commission, how are you improving the life chances of disabled people?
First of all, I would like to say that I'm working in the European Social Fund, which in fact is the instrument that we have in order to promote social policies and employment policies, including those of people with disabilities. Now, we have a whole policy, let's say, framework within which member states should work on disability, and the European Social Fund supports these policies through co-funding the operational programs of the member states that are adopted for a period of 7 years, and the people with disabilities are in fact one of the main target groups. And we have also more specific policies in place, in particular one that relates to the transitions from residential institutional care to community-based alternatives, with the aim to provide for every person with a disability the possibility to live independently, in line with the provisions of the UN Convention for the People with Rights to Disabilities.
Thank you for that, Marianne. Tell us, are you getting any learning or understanding of the impact these policies are having on the ground?
Yes, we are getting feedback, first of all, from the member states, because you know, the European Social Fund is what we call a shared management fund. So all the programs are followed both at the level of the member states, but also from the Commission side. Then one of the new principles of the fund is to include more and more the partners, the stakeholders that are working on the ground, including NGOs, foundations, but also labor and management. And of course, you get reports from those organizations back. And third, we also have what we call the transnational cooperation under the European Social Fund, whereby we promote exchange of good practice and mutual learning between member states, and from there, from this source, we get information of what's happening on the ground.
And are you positive about that feedback?
I am positive about what is possible to be done, that there are many doors open. On the other hand, it's something different to see plans on paper, and it's different what comes in reality after those have been implemented. And in fact, we have had recently the case whereby the Ombudsman at European level, Mrs. O'Reilly, launched an investigation relating to mishandling of what we call the structural funds when it comes to promoting social inclusion measures, and in particular when it comes to respect the Charter of the Fundamental Rights. So, you know, we are not always in a position to have a clear idea of what member states are doing with the funds that have been agreed to be given to them on the basis of a specific work program.
But I suppose it's reassuring to know that there are some checks and balances in place, like the European Ombudsman, who you can rely on, hopefully, to unearth bad practice or bad behaviour.
Yes, and on the other hand, also from our side, we have also committed to take measures in order to provide guidance to the member states as to better respect these provisions of the Charter of the Fundamental Rights, that in particular promote the right to the independent living and not institutionalisation of people with disabilities.
Finally, Marianne, I wanted to ask you about the role of social innovation. What are you at the Commission doing to promote social innovation on this issue?
there have been a lot of discussion about what is social innovation and what can be done, in particular as regards employment and social policies. My own personal feeling is that social innovation is a term that can be interpreted in many ways, and also what is innovative in one context within a member state is a common practice in another one. So, in fact, in this area of work, a lot needs to be done in terms of exchange of good practice, and the ones should inspire from the other. And on the other hand, one element that is crucial for success of social innovation is the multi-holder approach, that it has to be pluralistic, and it has to include not only the member states' authorities, but also the regional or local authorities who are best in place to know the specific needs on the ground. Again, also the social partners, the civil society organizations, when it comes to people with disabilities, the what we call DPOs, the disability people organizations, and also every other stakeholders like the foundations, for example.
Marianne Paraskeva, thank you for being Dialogue with European Foundation Centre.
Thank you.